Welcome to this M2 Technologies Tech Tip on managing layers in EdgeCam. Even simple CAM files can have a variety of toolpath, part geometry, and other relevant items. Good layer management makes it possible to quickly find the items you want to work with at the time you're ready to work with them. The layers window is configured as an auto-hiding window in the default software interface. It can be pinned and docked as desired, and we're going to do that for purposes of this training video. If you don't have this layer window visible, you can turn it on by going to the Windows drop-down list and choosing Layers, and that will add it to your interface. Working in the Layers window, if we right-click over any layer, notice that there's an action menu. This action menu provides the layer management commands. We have actions to show or hide layers, to create new layers, to make default, and some other common actions. We'll explore those during the course of this tech tip. Let's begin by turning off visibility of the machine and of the fixture and zoom extents on the part. I want to point out now that if I right-click over the stock layer and choose hide, that all of the items on that layer are now removed from the view. Notice also that the show column now says no in it. I can also hide toolpath layers. So as I hide the layers that are assigned a different toolpath, you may notice that toolpath visibility turned off in the display. On, off. Now right there what I did is I double clicked in the show column over the layer name and it toggles the visibility on or off. It's possible to sort the columns by clicking on the title for show to sort them with no at the top or with yes at the top. By default though, the layer list is organized by name. Names are put in an alphanumeric list. So we're going to go through the process of creating some new layers and watch how that's influenced. If I right click and make a new layer, let's call this new layer. Notice that that layer is put into the list in its correct alphanumeric spot in the list. Also notice the red box on here. This designates the active layer, and we're going to come back to that in just a moment. I can right click over this layer and go to properties. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to the beginning of that name and I'm going to simply add a space. So there's space and then new layer. Spaces, special characters, numbers, and other things are going to influence the layer list. Notice that simply by adding a space, space comes before special characters, numbers, and then letters. And so this layer is now the top layer shown in the list, simply by intentionally adding that separate character. Okay, let's go back to that red box and explain what the active layer controls. If I go to the stock layer, right-click over that, and I make it active. Notice that that ships the red box to that layer, even though the layer was not visible. Whether a layer is visible or not doesn't impact whether a layer is active or not. The active layer is the one where any new geometry that we construct in the CAM session will be assigned to. So if I turn on this layer temporarily, and let's go add some rapid approach points. Looking at this from a term perspective, let's begin the point command now. And I want to point out that the stock layer is the active layer. So as we choose the point command, the software asks for the position for point, and notice that on the picking tab, which automatically pops up whenever we're working with new things, notice that we have access to the layer. I can change the layer on the fly. If I do nothing, the new points will be created on the stock layer. If I go to the drop-down menu, we can choose any layer from this list. So for example, I can go choose that new layer we constructed as the layer to assign the points to. In the same way, we can also assign the color. We'll continue with the bright red color that's already active. You want to do that before you start creating the entities, because that's where you're going to be able to find the entities later. So for position for point, we're going to place this point at X5 inches and Z1. We can see the point created on the screen. Because of what I explained earlier, we know that that point is on the new layer layer. Well, how can you tell? One way to tell is simply turn on IntelliSnap. And we'll hover over that point. And notice that the software tells us that it is a point, and it's on the new layer. What if we want to change that? One way to change that is to change the name of the layer. So if I right-click and go into Properties, we can change the name of this. We'll keep the space, approach points. The space keeps it at the top of the list. So we've changed that approach points layer, and as I turn on or off its visibility, we can see the corresponding geometry on that layer turn on or off as well. It's also possible to directly edit entities. So if we move over that point with the mouse and simply double click, we can directly edit that individual item. That could include changing its layer and also its color. So if we change the layer here, I could simply type a new layer on the fly if I want to. So let's put in a new layer called Try This. When I press OK, notice that there's a new layer called Try This that was created. When I take this layer and turn it on or turn it off, the point has been moved to that layer. Another thing to keep in mind when moving geometry and changing the layer is that in this case here we changed a single item. What if we had a whole bunch of items? We wouldn't want to go one by one through each of them and change them. When you want to change multiple items, we would typically use the Apply to All command. Apply to All allows us to take as many items as we want to work with. So perhaps I could stretch a window, for example, and grab all of the items we want to work with. And once I've selected them and finish, the software asks what color do I want to make all of them. If I don't want to change colors, I can leave them alone. We can go over to Layer, and let's put this back on the Approach Points layer. One other quick tip to throw out there is that when you're working on the machining side, perhaps the sequence window is already active, and we may want to turn on or off toolpath display. Notice that here in the sequence list we can also do that. In this case I have a grouped folder view. I can right click over this tool and I can turn on or off the display layer. When I turn off display layer, the tool visibility here goes gray, and on the screen the toolpath's been removed. I can easily turn it right back on by right clicking over that. If we had the more traditional non-grouped, maybe the default grouping, so we don't have things grouped by tool, I can right click over the tool itself, and again the same, display the layer or not display the layer. One final thing to note is that if you're working on a part and you don't remember exactly what the layers were and want to quickly turn on or off visibility, a quick way to do that is working from the layers window, right click over anywhere in the space, including even the unused area. Notice the option called Select to Hide. With Select to Hide, I can choose this. The prompt tells us that all we need to do is select an entity that's on the layer we want to exclude or make not visible. So here I can select that point that's on the screen. I don't know which layer it's on, I can still select it, finish, and the layer that was on has now been hidden from view. We're hopeful these tips help give you some ideas on how you can use layers with your part. Good layer management makes it possible to quickly find the items you want to work with at the time you're ready to work with them.